Welcome to the state Augustine Alligator Farm Zoological Park and welcome to our beauty demonstration. Now before we get started, I just want to go over one quick rule. If you have anything that's not directly attached to your body, we do not leave it over that fence, rest it on those toes or on that inside lip. If there were a problem, I can give you an injury, but you don't want that to happen. That being said, we do understand accidents happen, so if you drop anything here or any of our other enclosures today, please let your staff member know, and we'll do what we can if we can save your tree that item. That being said, we're ready to see the alligator feet. Alright. Now, this is just the beauty demonstration. We have over 250 American alligators in our swamp. We're going to pair up a lovely American crocodile. I'll be sure to put those out if they make it up to the show. But I've got two items on the menu. First thing with this little pellet here, I'm sure it doesn't look like much, but it's something we can call on here as our croc pellet, and they absolutely love it. And everything a alligator or crocodile needs is a long, healthy life. We got crocodile biologists, vets, and even our own staff put it out together and decided to know what we need to put these animals long, healthy life. We put it all in this little pellet. It floats, so it's really easy to grab all over the water. And the best thing is, they absolutely love it. So it's made by a company called Missouri. They're a partner of Purina, so the same people that make your dog cat food, they got an alligator food. So as you can tell, they absolutely love that stuff. But in case you want something a little more exciting, how about friends? Now, they get everything they need from those dogs, but it's nice to use the fuzz, the guts, the blood, the bones, all the fun stuff in this furry little happy. Alright, who wants a rat? Somebody wants it. There we go. They help fill it up by standing on each other's back. Now, currently on the Husker Web Hunt, we were founded in 1893. This is not our original location. We're across the street where Anastasia State Park is. But in the 1920s, we were just over here to flood and fire another natural disaster. In 1937, we were purchased by the Trisdale family, and they helped grow this park quite a bit. We went from just having American alligators to all 24 species of crocodilians, reptiles, and all the birds and mammals that you see out there today. So we've been around for a long time, over 125 years in that time. We have been committed to the highest standard of animal care, the further picture of conservation and education. Now, alligators are what we call generalist carnivores, so if they've got meat, they're going to eat it. So they eat insects, birds, reptiles, mammals, really anything that they can get their mouth around. Like a nice juicy rat. There we go. Got a nice jump from him. So when you're even pressing these alligators, you're getting as big as some of our biggest ones in here, which are around 12, 11 feet. You need to eat something like a large deer. Now, there's some issues with that because alligators can't chew. So when they get those really rams, how they can break it down into smaller bites so they can actually swallow them. So if you watch when I pull this rat out, it might kind of look like this alligator is chewing. Who wants the rat? Somebody wants it. So it looks like he's chewing that, but he's actually putting that into the right position, and then he's just going to swallow it. Their jaws don't have the ability to chew. They have 78 conical teeth that are just used for puncturing and holding on. So when they find something bigger that they want to eat, they're going to do what media has dubbed the death roll. And that's not necessarily the way to kill their prey, but it's actually a gruesome